This is the fifth video of my multi-part video series on how to analyze a stock. In this video, we will discuss about quality of management. If you have not already seen the earlier four videos in the series, I would strongly recommend you to view them first for a better understanding of this video. I request you to read through the disclaimer. We are now in step 1 of the 7 steps in stock analysis. In step 1, there are two activities. One is analyzing the quality of business and the other is analyzing the quality of management. We discussed the quality of business in the previous video. In this video, we will focus on quality of management. How important is quality of management? Before discussing about this further, let us quickly see a few real-life examples. Chit fund is a common mode of investment in many parts of our country. Imagine if you were to invest in a chit fund. Would you entrust your money with a person with shoddy credentials? Or would you invest your money with a person having a good reputation, even if the returns are slightly lower? Then looking at the second case, you are going to buy a gold. What do you look for? Even if you pay slightly more per gram, you look for a jeweler with impeccable reputation so that you get pure gold. Consider the last scenario. You have to mortgage your gold jewelry for an urgent finance need. What would you look for? You look for an option who will safely return your jewels when you return the borrowed money. In all three cases, you are looking for the quality of the person or the reputation of the company and the past record. It is no different when it comes to the management of a company. Evaluating management integrity and other parameters is crucial for successful investment. The quality of management determines the future growth of the company as well as safety and growth of our invested money. Are there some qualities and attributes for a good management? Yes, there are three, mainly three. First one is competence, which is the minimum skill that is required to do the task in hand. The second one is integrity. This is about executing the task in a honest manner and also fair treatment of minority shareholders. And the last one being passion. This is the enthusiasm what the management personnel has in doing the task, be it growing the business or enhancing shareholders' wealth. To better explain, let us assume a situation where you have a driver for your car. Let us see how these three qualities stack up in this example. First quality is competence. The driver must be competent enough to drive in all conditions like city traffic, highway, day, night, rainy weather and so on, and still take you safely to the required destination. Your driver should not sleep on wheels, otherwise you will lose your sleep. You will always end up keeping an eye on the driver for the entire journey. The second is integrity. Imagine you gave rupees 2000 to driver to fill that fuel. The driver fills fuel for rupees 1800 and pockets the rest. Would you compromise and have the driver? No, you will not have the driver even for a minute extra after this. Then the third one is passion. Any driver would work for a paycheck. Instead, imagine this guy is driving, is his passion, and paycheck comes next. This is a very rare virtue. He enjoys driving, is stuck in a traffic even without being told. He chooses an alternative route and reaches the destination on time. He has been never late to duty, and you are always on time for your appointments. Your schedules was always your driver's priority. Now let us relate these qualities in business management. The first quality, competence. The person running the show must be competent enough not only to run the day-to-day business but also navigate the business in all conditions like economic slowdown, increasing competition, tightening regulations, etc. Even if there is an economic boom, still the person should be competent enough to exploit that situation and grow more. The second is integrity. There are two aspects to this. One is how the business itself is run, how the business objectives are met, whether it is being done ethically, are taxes being paid properly and so on. The second is the management's approach towards the minority shareholders. The management must treat the minority shareholders in par with promoters and other majority shareholders. The third is the passion. The key person passion about business, whether he is very ambitious and loves to see the company grow. He learns from failures, sees challenges as opportunity, and comes out big after every downturn. Shareholders' wealth creation is accorded priority. Have an open mind. Before we discuss any further, let me put a small caution. The most important thing that we need to have in mind when analyzing management is that we need to go with an open mind to gather and analyze all facts. One big barrier in management analysis is that we normally have an existing idea for or against the management based on some few initial inputs or discussion by or about management in the media and social media and so on. These prior opinions hinders the analysis in either one of the two ways. The first way is you already have a positive opinion about the managerial team or the person for their charisma and ignore any other data points that goes against them. You may even go to the extent of justifying the findings that go against them or specifically look for only information that is in favor of the management. The second scenario is you already have a negative impression about the management, then you may not be serious in doing a proper or a full research about the management. Since the management is not good, the investment idea becomes a low prospect idea and hence no further interest to analyze the company seriously. So, irrespective of the prior information you have, please go with an open mind, gather all data, analyze all the information, and make a decision without any attached emotions. So now we come to the important part, how to gauge managements. Analyzing management quality is not an easy activity like analyzing a company's financial performance and concluding whether it is a good or bad management. A 5 or 10 year company's financial performance can be found in many websites which share details about various financial ratios, technical charts and so on. But there will be no tab where you can find an analysis pointing out to the quality of management. This is because it's not possible to put a numerical value or is there any formula or is there a ratio or specific metric to gauge the quality of management. Even an exact definition of bad or good management is subjective and not straightforward. So what is a bad management? A simple, a straightforward pointer would be bad managements do all that is possible to benefit themselves at the cost of minority shareholders. So when you start analyzing the managements, where do you get information which will help you to analyze? There are three main sources of information. One is annual reports. In Indian annual reports, there is a section called as MGT9, which has a lot of information about the company and the management personnel. The second source is articles and interviews by or about the promoters that comes in various forms of media. The third is direct interactions with the promoter through con call, investor presentations, and annual general meetings. Even if you are not able to attend the con calls, most of the companies share the con call transcripts in their websites. That also becomes handy if you can pick up last few quarters and go through them. The analysis of management is a heavy topic to discuss in this video series, as the series is intended to only take you through the various high-level steps in analyzing a stock. However, if viewers are interested to know more about management quality, let me know your views in Twitter or YouTube comments. I will make a separate detailed video series on various pointers for gauging managements. I guess that such a series may run anywhere from 5 to 8 part video series with each running between 15 to 20 minutes. If you are interested to know more about such pointers immediately, kindly refer chapter 7, 8 and 9 from the book The Investment Checklist by Michael Sheehan. There are a few good pointers available in this book. Let me repeat that the subject is quite exhaustive. However, in the interest of simplicity to fit into the series, we will discuss 5 pointers in detail. So have in mind that management analysis is not only about these 5 pointers, but there are many more. So what are those 5 pointers? The one is management background, second, past performance, third, executive compensation, fourth, related party transactions, and fifth one is acquisitions. Of these five, we will see only the first pointer in this video, and the remaining four I will discuss in the next video that I will be releasing next week. So let us see the first pointer, promoter background. Under the quality competence, there are three sub pointers: education qualification, experience details, the length of tenure, that is the number of years the CEO and the top management has been associated with the company. Let us see how this would pan up with the help of an imaginary example. Let us assume that there is a promoter who heads a diagnostic laboratory service. He has done his post-graduation and doctorate in that field. So that goes for his educational qualification. He has got a total experience of close to 40 years. That goes for his experience details. He has been CEO in this company for close to 20 years. This covers the length of tenure. He has well thought about future and has a perfect succession plan. He has discussed in interview appearances of grooming his two children in this business. This eliminates the one man or the key personal risk. Then coming to the second attribute, that is integrity. Check if the key management person or any person on the board has any pending investigations or fines slapped by SEBI or any fraud or disputes or any inquiry pending and so on. Also check for the past decisions and how much it was in the best interest of the minority shareholders. That is to do about shareholder friendliness. To extend this to the same imaginary example, the CEO voluntarily accepts rupees 1 per month as a salary. Only 1 rupee per month as a salary. So this could be a good indicator of his shareholder friendliness. So this was just an imaginary example. Any similarity with any company is just a coincidence. So it is now time for actions. I hope you have followed up with the actions from the previous 3 or 2 videos, where you are required to identify a few companies based on some techniques like screeners or what you see, what you do and so on, and also analyze the quality of those names, quality of business for those names. Now you have seen one pointer for analyzing quality of management for those companies which you have already identified, and also analyze the quality of business. Check the promoter background. Try to find out who is the key person, what is his education qualification, since how long he has been CEO of the company. Try to check it from the annual report as well as from open source of information that is available in the internet. Good luck. Thanks for watching this video. Please do share any of your questions in the comment section, and my channel Empowering with Financial Awareness covers topics on personal finance and stock analysis. Do subscribe to the channel so that you get alerts next time I upload a video. And if you like this video, please do share with your friends. Thank you.